In this video, we are going to talk about the isomers of C3H9N and their IUPAC names. Let us first determine the degree of unsaturation, which is equal to 1 plus number of carbon atoms plus number of nitrogen atoms by 2 minus number of hydrogen atoms by 2, and therefore that is equal to 1 plus 3 plus 1 by 2 minus 9 by 2. This is 4.5 minus 4.5, and therefore the degree of unsaturation in this case is 0. That means no double bonds or rings possible for this elemental composition. We can definitely write propane 1 amine CH3 CH2, CH2, NH2. This is propane 1 amine. We can move the NH2 group to the second position, CH3, CH, NH2, CH3. This is propane 2 amine. By the way, both of them are primary amines. In the case of amines, you just need to see how many carbon atoms that the nitrogen is attached to. That's all you need to see. If instead of NH2, if OH was there, you would have called this as secondary alcohol, isn't it? But there you are seeing that carbon atom bearing the OH group is connected to how many carbon atoms. But here we should not see like that. We should see the nitrogen atom is connected to how many carbon atoms. That's what you need to worry about. And therefore, both of them are primary amines. Let's go to isomer 3. We can also write H3C, NH, CH2, CH3. This is N-methyl ethanamine. That's the correct IUPAC name, N-methyl ethanamine, and this is a secondary amine because the nitrogen atom is connected to two carbon atoms. Number 4, we can also write CH3, N, CH3, CH3. This is N, dimethyl methanamine. That's the correct IUPAC name. This is a tertiary amine. The nitrogen atom is connected to 3 different carbon atoms, and therefore this is a tertiary amine. So in total, 4 isomers are possible for C3H9N.